Hello there. Today we're going to learn about hash tables, how they work, how they can be implemented, and a few tricks to speed up your own implementation. The main idea is to map a key to an index. So we start by creating an array, and now we have to find something to transform our key into a number. To do that, there are mathematical functions that takes an input and return a fixed size output. Those functions are called hash functions. You may have heard about SHA-1, SHA-56, but those are cryptographic hash function and generally used for file checksum. What we want is something fast, and those are non-cryptographic hash functions. Once we have generated a number from our key, we have to map it to the table space. And the simple way to do that is to use the model operator. Now we have an index for our array, and we can store the information. In general, hash table stores a key and a value. For simplicity, the drawing just shows the key. Now, it's easy to understand why hash tables are considered fast. You take a key, you transform it to a number, you map it to the table, and bam, you store the item at a specified slot, or you look up the value at that slot. So let's try with another key. We take the key, transform it to a number, and map it to the table. Easy. Let's add another one. We take the key, transform it to a number, and map it to the table. Again, we take the key, transform it to a number, and map the table. One more. We take the key, transform it to a number, map it to the table. But this time, at the index, we have already an item, so we have a conflict. Handling conflict is the complex part of hash table implementation. There are many ways in which we can handle conflicts. And as you may imagine, there are lots of different hash table implementation. So let's see a few ways to handle conflicts. Since we are mapping a number to a small space, the array length, it's easy to understand that if we have a good hash function and we have a large enough table space, probably there will be no conflicts. So increasing the table size is a simple solution. But in practice, at some point, due to memory limitation, we will end up with conflicts. So we have to be able to handle them. A simple approach is to use a linked list to store items. If we have already something in the slot, we add it to the list. When we want to look up the value, we scan the list and compare the key until we find the one we are looking for. This approach is called chaining. But as you may expect, if the table is small, and there are a lot of collision, our hash table will no longer be good in terms of performance since we are doing a linear scan. So another approach for chaining is to use a binary tree instead of a linked list. Now we can do a binary search and it will be better, but still not as good as we hoped at the beginning. So every once in a while, it's better to resize the table. As a general rule, the table size should be 20% larger than the number of items. In this way, if the hash function is good, collision should be low, and our linked list or binary tree should be small enough. An alternative to chaining is called open addressing, and it tries to avoid storing items in a separate data structure. So let's see how we can handle conflicts. A simple approach is called linear probing, and the idea is we scan through the array from the slot that the key is expected to be in until we find a free slot. In this case, the next one. Cool, let's add another item. The slot 3 has already an item in it. We check the next slot, but there is already an item in it. So we move on. The slot is free, so we place the item in there. With this approach, to look up an item, we find a slot, and we start iterating over the array, comparing the key, until we find the one matching. In the worst case, we iterate every item in the array. A similar technique is called quadratic probing, and the only difference is that instead of trying the next element, we jump a few slots, first 1, then 4, then 9, and so on. By tuning the calculation of the next index, you can get very different performances. A different approach is double hashing. If we have a conflict, we use a second hash function to calculate another index. Given the same key, we will get a different number, and that number will probably map to a different slot. But at this point, you may have the hang of it and start realizing that you will always end up with conflict. And the solution will end up being resizing the table, chaining the elements, or trying the next slots. And many other techniques to deal with the collision are basically doing that, mixing multiple approaches to speed up the insertion and lookup times. Now you should have an idea of how hash table works, but let's see a few tricks to speed up your own implementation. Use power of 2 for the length of the table. In this way, you can replace the model operator with an AND, which is faster. Keep in mind to resize your hash table every once in a while, especially when the number of items are above the 75% of the table length. Comparing keys may be slow, especially if they are strings. So near the key, you should store the full hash value and check that first. If the hash function is good, most of the time you'll not have to compare the key. If you're going to implement chaining, instead of a traditional linked list or binary tree with nodes, use a table. In this way, you'll get some prefetching and performance should be better than a traditional pointer chasing approach. So that's it for today. Thanks for listening. And if you have a question or want to learn more, leave a comment.